everybody. Happy Wednesday. It is I, your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend, Joe Seabee. Happy Wednesday, guys. And Wednesday is part of our creative writing series that we like to call ghostwriting. And ghostwriting is when we take a popular Billboard charted song and we change the chorus, replace the chorus lyrics with our own lyrics, okay? Usually I do new songs, like brand new songs on Billboard. But today, again, I went a little retroactive and I went back in my time machine and I found a song from earlier in the 2000s by a guy named Jim Morrison, James Morrison, not Jim Morrison from The Doors, but James Morrison. He has a song, he has a lot of great songs, but one of the songs is called I Can't Stop the Rain. I love that song. And so again, let me get back to the exercise. So what we do in this class, and it's a really good chops building class. That's why we do it. What does that mean, a chops building class? Well, you know, we're taking someone else's song, keeping the melody, the music all the same, but just replacing all of their words in the chorus with our own original words. Sort of like a parody. You know what a parody is, right? Well, we're doing a parody, but not a funny take. We're doing, you know, we're making it, you know, we're just trying to rewrite a chorus as good as what's already there. That's the goal. I don't know if it's ever, you know, we never do it, but, you know, I mean, we're always trying to get better. So as a student of music myself, I'm always trying to get better. And these are little tricks that I've been doing over the years to try to get better at my craft. Also, it forces you to take a song that you've listened to for years, especially with a song as old as this one, and unlearn it and unthink it and, you know, put new lyrics on it. It's really tough. It's like if you were changing the words to Happy Birthday or the Star Spangled Banner, you know, with something completely different, you know, why do I feel so bad? My head hurts and my legs, you know, I mean, I'm just making it up right now, but you know what I mean? You're taking, oh, say, can you see? That's the melody, but you're changing all the words in it to your own words. Now, I'm just being silly on what I just did with the Star Spangled Banner, but it gives you an idea of where I'm coming from. And the other good reason, the other thing it's really good for is it just makes you have to think and come up with a story for a song. And of course, it's got to rhyme. It's got to make sense. It's got to tell a story of some sort of story. Okay. And like whatever the original song's about, it can be about the same idea. We just can't use any of the same words, you know. If it's a song about, you know, somebody, you know, broke up with you and you're crying and upset over it, it can still be about that. You just can't use any of the same words, you know. And the other thing I always stress too, in all of these exercises as well, is it's not necessary, but, you know, if they have a one syllable word, you should try to write a one-syllable word. But today, I broke all those rules. As far as, I didn't break the rules. I'll repeat myself. When he starts and stops, I start and stop. So if he had like a four-syllable word and I had four one-syllable words, as long as they all bounce the same time as his, that's all that matters. That's really the only thing that matters. And I don't make words longer or like make, you know, each line longer than the real line. So that's really important, you know. These are things to remember when you're doing this. And the other thing I always stress too, and it's so important, is when you're doing these, I want you to go in a room by yourself. And I want you to watch the lyric video. Well, I'm going to show you the lyric video in a minute here. you know, because I really do want you guys to, you know, listen to the lyric first and really get a sense of it. And then once you have it, then start writing down your ideas next to, but you know what, write down their lyrics and then you write your lyrics directly on the bottom of those lyrics. Like, I'm going to show you, this is what I did earlier. See, it says his, and then it says mine, his, mine, his. So like I wrote his first line and then I write my line right underneath of it, so that I can see how many syllables it's all going to be and all that kind of stuff, right? So that's really important. That's really important. Sorry about that, you guys. I jumped the gun a little bit. That is what I did. And I want you guys to do the same thing. So write the first line of the original lyric up there, and then right underneath of it, leave room for yours and see. If, like I said, if there's three syllables in that word, try to write a three-syllable word in yours. But if you only have three one-syllable words and they line up perfectly with the three-syllable word, then that, I'm good with all of it. All right? So, just so you know. So, what I'm going to do right now is now, sorry about before, I'm going to play you the chorus. So, here's James Morrison's chorus to I Can't Stop the Rain. If it's gonna be a rainy day, there's nothing we can do to make a change. We can pray for sunny weather, but that won't stop the rain. Feeling like you got no place to run, I can be a shelter till it's done. We can make this last forever. The time was on our side. I've put in far too many years to let this pass us by. So that's his chorus, okay? So now you heard the lyric, right? So you saw the lyric come up as the song's playing. And so now I can actually read you the lyrics too. If it's going to be a rainy day, there's nothing we can do to make it change. We can pray for sunny weather, but that won't stop the rain. You're feeling like you've got no place to run. I can be your shelter till it's done. We can make this last forever. So please don't stop the rain. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Please don't stop the rain. Let it fall, let it fall, let it fall. Please don't stop the rain. So that's his lyric, okay? So what I wrote was, so he says, if it's gonna be a rainy day, I wrote, every time I look into your eyes. And then his second line is, there's nothing we can do to make a change. I wrote, I can't believe this is our last goodbye. So mine is, every time I look into your eyes, I can't believe this is our last goodbye. All our good times spent together, and I still feel the pain. I'm crying cause I'm still not over you. I can't believe the pain you put me through. I know I can't make you love me. And that's what brings the pain to my heart, that's what brings the pain to my heart, that's what brings the pain. So, and like I said, I wrote it right underneath, here's his, here's mine, here's his, here's mine. I write them right underneath, and I make sure that they all line up. When he starts, I start. When he stops, I stop. It's all very, you know, thought out. And this is something, like I say all the time, you guys got to go in a room by yourself, shut the door, no distractions. I want you to really listen to these choruses. And then I want you to grab your pen and paper, write down all his words, Write down yours, leave a space so you can write yours underneath of each line of his. There you go. So I found a karaoke version of this song, so I'm going to do it for you right now. So here it is. That's the whole thing. All right, guys, I can't wait to see what you write for this chorus. This is a great song. And I can't wait to see what you guys write for it. All right, guys, that is all the time we have for tonight. This is your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe CB signing off. Have a lovely night, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Peace.